$40,000. We are officially in buy the dip season, where all you got to do is hold your Bitcoin, and when it goes down, you buy the dip. Today, we are covering this huge move by Bitcoin and then looking at some of the potential supports and resistances as Bitcoin is now in major discovery mode. So I know a lot of you might be freaking out because of that huge dip, but we got you. Stay tuned. What's up, Jay here, and welcome to Bitcoin Daily, bringing you guys the best tips, tutorials, and ideas to help you guys learn how to become a profitable and successful trader. On this channel, we often cover market analysis, market news, reviews, tutorials, and we teach you how to trade so you could get to that next level. So if you're new here, hit that subscribe button. If you've been here before, then make sure to hit the like button and leave us a comment. Let us know what you guys think about what's going on currently with Bitcoin. Make sure to hit that like and subscribe, guys. We're at 2,600. We're almost at 3K. Our last few videos been getting 40, 50 likes and almost 1,000 views, guys. I appreciate your support, guys. The channel is blowing up. So let's keep it going, guys. Let's jump right in. All right, guys, so let's go ahead and take a look at the chart. Let's start off on the daily. As you guys can see, man, we've had an insane ride. This has been crazy, guys. You know, we've been tracking this ride from the beginning, man, and it's just been insane to watch this grow, right? Here we are, guys. We made it to 20,000. We made it to 40,000, guys. Insane. We've literally doubled the previous all-time high when people said it couldn't be done. We did it. Year to date, we're already up about 38%, guys, on the year, leading all asset classes, probably leading all stocks, leading everything right now, I believe. All right, so we hit $40,567. Insane move today. As you guys can see, just an 8% move today only. Yesterday, we had another 8% move, and the day before, we had a 6% move. So it's been a crazy start to the year, guys, as you guys can see. Over almost around 40% in year-to-date profits. Just insane, 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 insane. So let's go ahead and take a look at this move. Let's zoom in a bit and try to understand the current levels and see where we might go from here, right? So as you guys can see, the move has respected the Fibonacci levels, right? So you see how it was stuck here at this Fibonacci level, and then when it finally broke above it, it had to test it a few times. So that level right there is around that 36,500 level, which if you think about it, it coincides with exactly where we dipped down to, right? So we had troubles right here, as you guys can see. Then we tested it a few times before we continued up. So that shows that this is a level that's being respected. That's the 36,500 level. So that's why it's no surprise that then when we had this dip, it dipped right down to 36,500. It literally dipped down to here where we had that support. So it all makes perfect sense. Obviously, hindsight is 20/20. But if you would have drawn this Fibonacci level up here as soon as it hit, you could have definitely seen this as a support right here. So we were able to, I took a few positions on the way back up. Now it was very risky, so I didn't signal it in my trade room. I didn't want to give any such risky positions, but I did enter a trade at 36.5 around there. Entered another one at 37, entered at 37.5, and I was able to ride it up a bit and make some profits on that move. But yeah, as you guys can see here, guys, there's nothing to worry about. Even this bar, this huge, even though it was a huge dip, it's green, guys. Look at that. It's still a green bar. So look at all this volume that happened there. just insane, guys, insane. We're still good. Obviously, the RSI is oversold, and we can. I don't know if we can expect to just keep going up, but if we continue, if we just break through this 40K, you know, I don't see nothing stopping us from hitting 50 at that point. The same thing I said when we broke 30,000. I said if we break 30,000, I don't see anything stopping us from hitting 40. And just like that, as soon as we broke that 30, look at this, we broke 30 over here. I have to look around. You guys see me on the camera looking like this, because I have to literally, the camera's in like on the side of my screen, so to see the lower left of my screen, I gotta kind of peek around it. So don't mind me. But as you guys see here at 30, this is where we broke 30, and then we just kind of took off all the way to about 35. Then we you know, bull flagged, and then boom, the run all the way up. So all the way to 40, just as I kind of said that, you know what I mean? I figured there was nothing else that was gonna hold us back. So I'm thinking the same thing. Once we break above 40, there's nothing that's gonna hold us back from hitting 50. So 50 is gonna be that next huge number. Remember, the big hole numbers is what the big market psychological numbers that people tend to sell at. So there's gonna be a lot of selling. Even here at 40,000, there's still gonna be a lot of selling. Like I don't know if we're just gonna break right through. We might need to consolidate a bit before we can continue up. So don't be surprised, guys, if we see kind of a bull flag right here. This could definitely be a play that happens here with a bull flag, kind of the same exact thing that happened down here, right? We had that huge bull flag down before we were able to continue up. And that happened right at that 30 to 35 range. That's when we kind of bull flagged and then took off. So that's kind of what we're looking at and what we're watching right now. Obviously, we don't know if that's exactly what's gonna happen yet, but that's currently what we're watching, and it's just kind of gotta wait and see at this point, right? Up next, we're gonna talk about Ethereum, because we know a lot of you were asking a bunch of questions about Ethereum as well. So that's what we're gonna cover right now. If you are new here and have not subscribed yet, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Just punch it a couple times for me, smash it, and smash the like button as well. And introduce yourself in the comments. I always read every single comment that's left. So go ahead and drop a comment with whatever questions you might have, and I will respond to you 100% guaranteed. All right, now looking at Ethereum, you guys can see that basically the same thing happened here. So when we hit around 1K, so you see 1K, we kind of bull flagged there. We had a bit of a bull flag, even though we stayed to the upside. Ever since we broke out of that small little bull flag, we just kind of took off. So now we hit 1300, and the next stop is 1400, which was the previous all-time highs. So I definitely see us breaking 13. However, I'm not sure when. So if Bitcoin continues up and it breaks 40K, we could see a break of 1300. If Bitcoin consolidates, we could see a break of 1300. But if Bitcoin drops hard, then Ethereum's gonna drop hard with it. So we're watching this, these levels right here, the two Fibonacci levels. So that's around that 1150 area. The next level after that is gonna be around that 1100 to 1175 area. And that's in between this Fibonacci level right here. Then the next area is gonna be right here, which is right at that $1,000 mark. And then the golden ratio is at 61.8%, which is around that 635 to 650 zone, right? So those are the zones that we're watching on, you know, if we get a retracement for Ethereum. But we expect maybe something similar, a bull flag like this, where it uses this right here as its main support, and it just kind of bounces off both of these until we have breakout. And then the breakout should lead to a test of the previous all-time highs. So that's kind of what we're watching. You know, both moves are very similar because, as you guys know, Ethereum is and Bitcoin have been very, very correlated during this run. So that's just kind of what we're watching right now, guys. Just wanted to do this quick little update for you guys. I know a lot of you were freaking out, and there's really nothing to worry about. This is, you know, obviously it was a huge sell-off, but as you guys can see here, the dip was definitely bought. So I'm just continuing to buy the dips right now. I don't see us dropping way down here or anything like that. So I'm just watching these levels right here that we just spoke about, and buying if I see it bouncing off of there. So I'm not giving any trade setups today, but on tomorrow's video we'll do we'll look at these at the charts again, and then I will give some trade setups for this weekend. That's it, guys. That's all we're covering today. Just wanted to touch on a few little things here and wanted to make sure that you guys knew that. Relax, everything's okay, we're good, guys. We've run up 38% this year already in 7 days. Chill out, it's okay for Bitcoin's price to take a breather. You don't gotta freak out, it's all good. Thank you, guys. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that subscribe button, hit that like, and drop a comment. Let us know what you guys think about the price action today, how crazy it's been, and if you're just holding right through it with some diamond golden hands. All right, guys, I will see you guys on tomorrow's video. As always, peace and love.